At 7 weeks of pregnancy, your baby is just about half an inch in size and weigh around 1 gram. It must be experiencing an overall growth and dynamic development in all the organs of the body. The developments are usually directed craniocaudal from head to toe. So, during this week, the nervous system is the most important system to lead the developments. The brain is specializing fast with the development of cerebral hemispheres, which will house the various centers of higher intelligence and finer skills. The cerebrum will empower your baby with the power of logical reasoning, interpreting touch, vision and hearing, articulation of speech, understanding and expressing emotions, learning, fine control of movements and memory. L-methylfolate, the active form of vitamin B9 or folic acid, plays a vital role in the synthesis of DNA and thereby facilitating the overall development and growth of your child, especially its brain and nervous system. DNA, the wonder molecule that is responsible for the inheritance of genetic information from one generation to another and which describes all the characters of the organism, including the development and functions of various organs, is present in the nucleus of all living cells as chromosomes and its genes. It translates the inscribed information through the production of various proteins. Therefore, folic acid supplementation is crucial throughout the pregnancy. The deficiency of folic acid can lead to lethal neural tube defect, resulting in the permanent disabilities in the child. Hope, as per recommendations, you might have already started folic acid supplementation. The foods that are rich in folic acid includes green leafy vegetables, fresh fruits, sprouts, cereals, wheat germ, legumes, beans, egg, liver, and they should be freely included in your meals. At this time, the 10 out of 12 cranial nerves begin to emerge from the brainstem. They would control the facial expressions, movements of jaw, neck and shoulder, digestive system and hearing. However, the two cranial nerves, the olfactory nerve that will provide the sense of smell and the optic nerves that will empower your child with the vision, would emerge at later part of gestational age as the higher center develops. The development of pituitary gland at the base of the brain marks the onset of hormone production by your baby. It would soon differentiate into anterior and posterior pituitary, producing battery of stimulatory hormones that will further control other hormone-producing endocrine organs, baby's growth, metabolism, and its vital functions. Presently, the baby's heart is fast acquiring adult four-chambered structure by differentiating into right and left atrium and ventricles, and it will soon beat at around 110 to 170 beats per minute. The lung buds begin to form by backward invagination of endoderm into surrounding mesoderm. The pipe-like common structure formed will gradually separate longitudinally into two tubular structures with respiratory tract trachea in front and foot pipe esophagus behind. In liver, the hepatic glands and vascular channels grow. Initially, the red blood cells that carry oxygen in our body are produced in yolk sac and baby's liver until the bone marrow takes over its production. The mesonephrons that would form the kidneys and excretory system of the baby also begin to develop from the mesodermal layer. At this week, the primary sensory organs also begin to develop. In eye, the lens placard that would give rise to eye lens appear. The retinal pigments that will help your child in color differentiation and night vision also begin to form. In the inner ear, the auditory vesicles appear. It would give rise to the vestibular system that maintains body's equilibrium and balance, and the auditory system that will empower your child with the power to hear. The appearance of nasal placard marks the beginning of basic sense of smell. The five pharyngeal arches begin to develop in the region of neck. They would subsequently give rise to baby's mouth, pharynx, tongue, taste buds, teeth and the palate. The skin of your baby is initially translucent and paper thin. The upper and lower limb buds continue to grow with the development of slightly webbed fingers and toes. During the initial first 6 weeks of gestational age, the embryo follows all or none phenomena. That means any lethal damage to embryo by physical or chemical injury, exposure to radiations or harmful medications, the nature would terminate and abort the baby. However, the continuation of pregnancy indicates that the baby is absolutely unaffected by the injury and is completely normal. For example, if a seed hit with the hammer is damaged, it would not grow into a plant at all. But if it is unaffected, it will germinate and achieve its full potential as a plant. But here on, from 7th week until 13th week, as the various organs develop from their respective stem cells derived from the three germinal layers, the baby is at maximum risk of developing respective teratogenicity and permanent structural and functional disabilities. Therefore, to ensure the safety of your baby, you should avoid any kind of harmful food, medications or radiations. As the pregnancy advances, it is advisable for you to undergo first trimester screening during 11th to 13th week of gestation and anomaly scan between 19th to 22nd week of gestation to diagnose any structural and chromosomal abnormalities in the baby. Shortly, due to hormonal changes, you may experience nausea, vomiting, easy fatigue, lethargy, mood swings, and emotional lability. The Mother Nature has formulated these symptoms to ensure that you take adequate rest, enough blood flow to the baby, and the baby grow safe and secure in your womb. Pregnancy is probably the best engineering of nature. Enjoy the beautiful journey of pregnancy, full of mysterious and wonderful experiences. May God always bless you and your baby. Best wishes. Happy pregnancy.